Hello friends, welcome back to my channel Saujanya's English class. And in today's class we are going to learn about kinds of coordinating conjunctions. Very important topic. There are four kinds of coordinating conjunctions: cumulative or copulative, adversative, disjunctive or alternative, and illative. Let's learn about cumulative or copulative conjunctions. As the name suggests, these conjunctions merely add one statement to another. They copulate statements. Some of these are and, both and, as well as, not only but also, etc. Let us see some examples. He entered the room and switched on the lights. First example. Second one, she is not only brainy but also beautiful. Next one, the lion is both ferocious and clever. Next example, Raj as well as Alex were qualified for final match. Next example, the elephant got up and walked away slowly. If you look at all these examples, here two statements are merely added, that's it. He entered the room and he switched on the lights, like that. She is brainy and she is also beautiful, like that. Next one is adversative conjunctions. These are a bit interesting as well. These conjunctions express contrast between two statements. Contrast, you know, two opposing ideas. Some of these adversative conjunctions are but, still, yet, nevertheless, whereas, while, however, etc. Let us see some examples. Manish is intelligent but he failed the test. Second example, the boy is ill, still he is happy. Next example, she is wealthy yet unhappy. Next one, Raj is hardworking whereas his brother is quite the opposite. Next one, there was little hope of success, nevertheless they decided to try. If you look at all these examples, they present contrasting ideas. Intelligent but failed the test, ill still happy, wealthy yet unhappy, hardworking opposite, little hope of success, they decided to try. So contrasting ideas. Next one is disjunctive or alternative conjunctions. As the name suggests, these conjunctions present us a choice, two alternatives. Sometimes it can be a choice as well. Okay, some of these alternatives are or, either or, neither nor, neither nor, otherwise, and else. Let's see the examples. You can have a toast or a burger. Second one, she is either stupid or cruel. Third one, he neither spends his money nor donates it. Next one, Raj doesn't play cricket, neither he likes it. Another way of saying it, Raj doesn't play cricket nor does he like it. Next one, you must hurry up, otherwise or else you will miss the flight. If you look at all these examples, you can see the choice, two variations between them. You can have either a toast or a burger. She is either stupid or cruel. You must hurry up, otherwise you will miss the flight. Two alternatives are presented in all these sentences. These are disjunctive conjunctions. Next one is illative conjunctions. These conjunctions express some inference from another statement. We have to understand from the another one. Some of these illatives are for, so, therefore, consequently, etc. Let us see some examples. Get yourself ready, for it's already late. She must be asleep, so the room is dark. Next one. He didn't study well, so, or therefore, or consequently, he failed. Next one. She has been working for days together, consequently, she fell ill. If you look at all these examples, you can understand that there is a reason, inference. That means we have to understand one statement based on the information given by other statement. Get yourself ready. Why? Because it's already late. That for is illative conjunctions, which is giving reason. Why did he fail? Because he didn't study well, like that. She must be asleep. How did you understand? Because the room is dark. Okay, based on another statement or fact. So this is all about kinds of coordinating conjunctions, dear. Please go through the lesson once again and try to participate in the quiz as well. Quiz time, friends. Very simple quiz as usual. Identify the kind of conjunction. That's it. First sentence, either he is eccentric or mad. Second one, Neeta baked the cake and Raj made the dinner. Next one. Somebody's here, for I heard the footsteps. Next one. He is quiet, humble, whereas his brother is rude. Next one. He is not clever, neither hardworking. Next one is Alex made many mistakes. However, the teacher did not punish him. Okay, so this is a simple quiz, my dear friends. Please go through the lesson once again. Read these sentences again and try to find out the kind of conjunction that is used in these sentences. Very simple, right? All the best. Hope this lesson has helped you, my dear friends. Meet you soon with another interesting video. And in the meanwhile, if you have any queries or any kind of requests, you can write it in the comment section, or you can contact me through my mail ID as well. And please like and share my videos, and please subscribe to my channel as well. Share these lessons with those who are in need, with your acquaintances, with your friends, with your classmates and all. Okay, bye for now, guys. Thank you so much for being with me.